When people are talking about the exploitation of a resource, say a forest or an animal population, it's very common to say that, well, of course, it must be sustainable. The problem is that in my experience, you ask people what they mean by sustainable exploitation, and they don't know. As I see it, there are six main definitions. And I'm going to illustrate these with this simple example, an open access fisheries. So this is the effort, the number of fishing boats. This is the catch, the value of the fish. Don't go fishing, and you obviously don't catch anything. Fish intensively, you drive the population extinct, and over the long term, you don't get anything. The first definition, the highest catch, the maximum sustainable yield, is this level here. Secondly, let's include costs, the cost of each fishing boat. Here, the biggest profit is made where those two lines are different, the maximum economic yield. Three, at this point, it's very profitable to fish. And if this is individuals acting independently, i.e. not as a community, then it makes sense to buy more boats and increase the effort. And keep doing so, because there's still profit and profit and profit, until the profit from the fisheries is balanced by the costs. And this game theoretical solution probably describes very many of our large fisheries. Fourth, exploitation doesn't reduce the natural population. The essence of exploitation is you take a population and you reduce it. There's now less competition, so it grows. And that growth can be exploited. So if you're not to reduce the population, then basically you can't take any. Fifth, some say you mustn't reduce the population any further. It must still be in harmony. Well, actually, that can apply to any level along here. At each of those, they're at some equilibrium. You can keep exploiting at that level. And then finally, it's often the case that there are individuals that want to increase the levels of exploitation and catch more. And there are individuals that want to maintain the population, conservationists. And the compromise between those two will determine what the level of exploitation is. So in summary, unless someone makes clear the definition they're using, if they say they want exploitation to be sustainable, then that is a meaningless sentence.